Good morning, and what a beautiful morning it is today. I want to thank Commander Benda and the sailors of Old Ironsides for hosting us aboard this storied warship, as well as the Honorable Rhea Zobel and James Nealon for taking part in this incredibly moving event. And I want to welcome Captain Tom Kelly, a sailor, a patriot, and a Medal of Honor recipient. Tom, are you out there this morning? Tom, it's good to see you. Most importantly, to our newest citizens, congratulations. How fitting it is to celebrate your naturalization in Boston, the birthplace of the American Revolution, on the deck of the USS Constitution, a warship that sailed and fought to secure the blessings of freedom when our nation was in its infancy. You hail from 10 different countries around the world, from Ireland to Ghana, from the Philippines to Jamaica, and your journeys in life have intersected at this precise moment in time. From this day forward, you will begin an American journey together. All of you have ties to the military. Four of you are currently serving in the Army, two are in the Navy, two are in the Air Force, and one is in the Coast Guard, and one is an Army veteran. Each of your stories is as unique as the countries, the cultures, and the loved ones that you've left behind. But the act of immigrating to your new home, to your new nation, is as old as America itself. The United States is and forever will be a nation of immigrants. At the dawn of our republic, many boarded vessels like this very ship and endured a harrowing voyage across the Atlantic. In many cases, immigrants confronted the treacherous seas with only the things that they carried on their backs. They battled famine and disease. Some were separated from their loved ones, and others paid the ultimate price. What compelled them to take this perilous journey? What drove them to leave all they hold dear and sail towards unknown shores and uncertain destinies? Hope. Hope of a better life and hope for a better future for their families. Hope drove them to endure adversity, and I believe hope is what drove you to this very moment this morning. Immigration is ultimately a step of faith, an act of hope. And this hope, this faith in America, is part of the lasting gift that you bring to our country. You, my fellow Americans, fill our communities and our nation with hope and with confidence. Your determination, your optimism, and heritage invigorates our cities and our towns, our businesses and our schools, and indeed, our armed forces. Immigrants serve as sailors, Marines, soldiers, airmen, and Coast Guardsmen around the world and stand watch for a nation that is not formally yet their own. One of our nation's mottos, E Pluribus Unum, out of many, one. America is comprised of people from all walks of life and from distant foreign lands, but we are a country united towards a common purpose. The belief that all people, all of us, are created equal, that all people, all of us, deserve the protection of the law, have the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. We are not a people defined by a common language, a common creed, or a common race. We are a nation characterized by its diversity and the power that that diversity fuels. Your stories and the cultures, the customs, and the traditions that you bring to America exemplify that we have more that unites us than that divides us. It is precisely this element of a shared life tied to a mutual set of principles that make America that shining city on the hill and why we continue to attract immigrants and shelter refugees from around the world. America is also importantly an unfinished nation. For nearly 2.5 centuries, we have labored to form a more perfect union, to realize the values that our founders espoused, and create a society where all people truly find equal opportunity and justice in our land. Because of this, we are always, always looking forward towards new beginnings, to new horizons, helping each other pursue their American dream with renewed help. It is with this great hope for our beloved America that we welcome you with open arms as citizens of our country. As you all know, with citizenship comes important responsibilities, as Your Honor has mentioned. We have faith that you will work to make your communities inclusive and resilient. Share your time and your talents with your neighbors and participate in our electoral process. Raise your children with our values and, if called upon, defend the rights that we cherish. Our nation is only as strong as its citizens. So whether you hail from Portugal, from Ghana, or from Venezuela, you are now charged with fulfilling the same civic duty as every other American. Together, we will dedicate ourselves to the common good with wisdom, confidence, and self-discipline. Together, we will commit ourselves to the highest principles of honor and justice towards our fellow countrymen. And together, we will seek to make a more perfect union. America is stronger today because you are a part of it. This is now your nation, this is your land, and your home for generations to come. I wish you all fair winds and following seas. God bless you, God bless your family and friends, and God bless this country that we love. Thank you.